Hello and welcome back to my sewing corner. If you're new here, you're very much welcome. Thank you for stopping by. Today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing us how to make a peplum blouse, okay? And I'm going to be showing us different types of peplum blouses. As you can see from this sketch, I have my peplum blouse here. A peplum blouse just comprises of your half bodies, from your shoulder to your waist, alright? Or if you're using your arm, your underbust as a reference point for the half length, from your shoulder to your underbust, okay? Then you have your peplum taking the other length, other measurements that complete your body's length or your blouse length, all right? So that's what we have for a peplum blouse. I've covered half bodies or bodice pattern in my other tutorials and you're gonna find them useful. So I'm going to link them in the description box. So these bodies, that is from your shoulder to your half length, can actually be a jacket, can actually be an overlap bodies, can actually be an off-shoulder bodies, can actually be a tube top, okay? So it doesn't have to be just straight basic bodies like this or a princess that's cut. It can be anything, so you can play around it, all right? So that being said, we're going to be focusing on the peplum parts, like I said. And a peplum, as you can see, just give fullness to your blouse, okay? It can even be on your skirt, can be anywhere, any part of your dress, okay? So it just gives fullness to that particular area where you attach the peplum to. So from this, your half length to the end of this flare, you can see here, is your peplum length. So you can see that that particular part could have been straight if you are just drafting the basic bodies that will end at your normal blouse length, but you have attached this to give what, fullness to that area, okay? So that being said, we have different types of peplum, and I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to be taking them one by one so that it can be as detailed as possible. Now let's talk about the first category. We have the circle peplum, okay? Now the circle peplum, we have different circles that can give fullness to your bodies or your dress or your sleeve or any part of your dress that you want to attach the peplum to. So we have the 180 degree flare. So I already have a tutorial on how to make a draft and even style a 180 degree flare, but I'm going to still touch it in this one. So if you want to check that one out, you can check it out. We also have a 270 degree circle, or we call it a 3/4 circle. That this is not the complete circle, it's not a complete full circle, 360 degree circle. And also we have a 360 degree circle flare. We have the 720 degree circle flare. So the 360 degree flare is just one circle. Now the 720 degree circle flare is two circles, comprised of two circles. Now we have the 1080 or 1080. That one is triple circle flare, okay? That one has three circles, okay? Now we have the 1440 or the 1440. That's the quadruple circle flare, okay? That one has what, four circles. I'm going to touch everything, just giving you a brief intro so that we can all have an idea of what I'm going to be talking about in this tutorial, okay? Now let's go to the other type of flare. The next one we'll be talking about here is the cone flare, or we'll call it the panel circle, the panel circle. So this one, I have a tutorial also on it, a detailed tutorial, so you can also check it out. But we can make your own panel circle to have six, your cone flare to have just what, six panels, 9 panels, 12 panels, 18 panels, and so on. So all of this is just about how much you can make alterations to fit your taste. So the next one we're going to be talking about is the pleats. So we have different types of pleats, and you know, pleats also give fullness because you're actually going to be folding some inches of your fabric to hide it at the upper part, and then you know, it flares out at the extreme end of that blouse or wherever you're attaching the peplum to. So it also gives fullness to that particular part of your body or your dress that you're attaching it to. So you have the box pleat, you have an inverted pleat, you have the knife pleat, you have the accordion pleat, and you have the kick pleat. So that being said, today I'm going to talk about circles, 180 degree circle flare. Now to make a 180 degree circle flare, please take note that a 180 degree circle flare is not going to be very full. It's not going to be as full as a 360 degree flare. It's not going to be as full as any flare that is more than 180 degree flare. Okay? So a 180 degree flare means you're just having half circle. 180, you know, a full circle is 360 degree. That means you're having half of it. So you can call it half circle. All right? So what it means is that you're going to need your waist measurements, all right, So you're going to need your overall waist measurement. You can make the calculations. So to make a 180 degree flare, all you need to do is to get a pattern paper or your fabric and just fold it into two in a diagonal way. So I'm going to show you what I mean. So here I have my pattern paper here, as you can see. So you see I have this part here, this straight part. This, let's say this is the horizontal part and this is the vertical part of my pattern paper. So for your fabric as well, you're going to have this part, you're going to have the horizontal part, you're going to have the vertical part. So what you're going to do is just to fold the horizontal to meet the vertical. Okay, now remember, like I said, you are making it what is a half circle. All you have to do is just to fold it in such a way that you can actually make adjustments to this depending on the fabric you have. For instance, if you're drafting this for a long dress, okay, you know, you need enough because of the length, you may not fold it completely like this. You may not give it this complete fold. Okay, so what that means is that you can actually do what, you can adjust this. You can see the way I'm shifting the backwards, so it's not meeting this vertical one, or the vertical one is not missing the horizontal one, so that I can have enough, the length of my dress will do. So if you are adjusting it, just know that you're reducing the fullness as well. Okay, so what you do, once you've adjusted it to your taste, what you're going to do is to divide, because you're having just two layers, so you're going to divide your waist circumference here, you're going to divide it by two. One thing I want you to know that anytime you fold your fabric or your pattern paper in this bias way or in diagonal way like this, you're not going to have this side and this side equal. So when you're folding your tape roll by the measurements you got, you know, the division you just did, because whatever you have gotten, you're going to divide it by two, like I said, and you're going to trace that out on this part of your pattern paper or your fabric. So because it's, you know, you don't have both sides equal, you're not going to just place your tape roll straight like this. If you place it straight, you see that one part is longer than the other side. So what you try to do, because it's curved, it's like a cone, you're going to bend your tape roll and you're going to tilt it. Okay, so you're going to tilt it in so that you can get the shape of a cone, as you can see me do. So you're going to tilt it. Okay, so once you can get the actual measurements you want, so this form, let me just mark this point so that you can cross check. All right, so you're just going to mark it like this. So whatever it is that you have there, so here I have what, 4 3/4. Now to cross check it, you're going to place your taper at this edge here, this top part here to this point, and also place it from here to here. Make sure that they're equal. Once both sides are equal, if you don't have both sides to be equal, that means you have to retake that cone measurement. Okay, so once you do that and you have both sides to be equal, you place your taper here and then you mark it at the midpoint. You can also mark it at other points so that you can trace it, you can, you know, curve it out, and you can have a perfect curve. All right, so having done that, you're going to place your tape roll here and then you take the length you want for your flare. Okay, so all you just need to do is to subtract your half body's length from your full body's length to get the length that you want, and that is how you can make a 180 degree flare. All right, so you can check that my tutorial on how to make a 180 degree flare is very detailed, and I actually showed you how you can even style it for an office dress. So watch out for the next one. I'm going to be talking on the other types of flare, 270 degree flare, and in that one I'm going to be drafting and cutting, because I don't have any tutorial on 270 degree flare. So watch out for it, stay tuned, share this with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed, please click on the red subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one.